All right, here we are at the Lilac Festival. Great place to be, and we got the breakfast this morning by the Lions Club. This is your first year, isn't it?
Yes, this is the first year for our pancake breakfast.
And you're Sean Mack, you told me.
Yep, Sean Mack.
So you're not lying.
No.
Okay,
not,
all right.
I am a lion, but I'm not lying.
We got that. So how's it going this first year with?
You know what? I had no idea what to think coming in today, but I'm pretty happy with how we've done so far. I think every opportunity to do more is better. So, you know, the first year event, now we kind of know some of the kinks to maybe work out for the next year.
Okay. All right. And now, was it your run this morning that they did?
No, that's the YMCA. The YMCA has been running the Purple 5K for a few years now.
Okay.
I'm also the director for our turkey trot, so I helped work with them because they had a new director for their race, and so we discussed just kind of marketing things together to get more people involved in both.
In both. And, you know, the Lions is a fine club. This is your 80th year, I believe.
Yep. January of this year would have been our 80th anniversary.
Wow, that's something. You've done a lot for this community. I don't think they understand how much you guys really do. Can you kind of give us a little rundown?
Well, first of all, our mission is sight conservation, so we do help people who are in need for eyeglasses and eye exams. There's an application they can fill out at the health department, and we will help them pay for those exams and glasses if they need it. But one thing I think a lot of people don't realize is that we are actually the directors of the Halloween parade. So we had, from 1946 to 2019, an uninterrupted Halloween parade that's put on by the Lions Club every year. Last year was the first year since its inception that we haven't had it. And then we've also got our turkey trot event, which this year will be the 24th annual turkey trot, which is a 4-mile run Thanksgiving morning at Independence Dam State Park.
Okay. All right. I know you had the one run. And I want to tell you, it broke my heart, too, because it's one of the first Halloween parades I missed, and I didn't get wet.
You know, it was actually really funny because in 2019 we had a lot of conversation because the weather was terrible, and the week leading up to it we just kept saying we don't want to be the group to miss a year. Well, lo and behold, we did. Not for the bad weather, but for last year, and as of now everything is on for this year to get it started and going again. So we're looking forward to that,
and I think so. We really need that. I think with all that we've been through community-wise, and especially the volunteer groups that they do a lot. You know, the service clubs here, people don't understand. It's the backbone of the community, and especially the Lions Club, because you do more than collect glasses.
Absolutely, and you'd be surprised. You know, we got our group out here right now, but the people down in the kitchen right now, maybe when you know, Jamie Blank is downstairs flipping pancakes for us.
What a surprise!
And Jeff Hahn. But yeah, no, I agree, because today is a great day. You know, my wife is actually the director of the Visitors Bureau, so she's running the Lilac Festival, and I came to her with an idea because we have another event we tried to start last year that we had to cancel. So I came to her with the idea of doing a breakfast with the Lilac Festival, and she just thought it was a great idea. So we just ran with it, and it's just been a nice day. And, you know, all the community involvement, that's what all of us are here for. So
it is. And it takes, I don't think people understand. I talk about volunteerism all the time. But even if you can give 1 hour, just 1 hour a day, just some weekend, some Saturday, when functions like this are going on, just to help load up when they're done. I mean, it's
absolutely the amount of time that a lot of us put into these events. You know, like I said, my wife is the director of the Visitors Bureau, so I get a lot of volunteer opportunities. But you know, that hour or two that you can help and set up and tear down, it's amazing what that does for an event like this, or for our Rib Fest, or you know, anything that we have in our community. Just that hour or two that really helps out the people who are out here all day long, you know, get moving.
Yeah, and that's true. And even after this festival, especially the Rib Fest, just to have volunteers help get the barrels back against the wall.
Yeah, there's been years that there's been two or three people who have torn down the Rib Fest.
Yes.
And that is not fun at 1 o'clock in the morning when you've been there since 6 o'clock the previous morning. So yeah, we've got some great volunteers around in the community. The schools are getting involved in helping. That's great to get the young people to understand these service yes. clubs and organizations, because that's what we really need. All the service clubs need new young members, because if we don't get them, they're going to end up dying out. And we don't want that, because you're right, people don't realize what all of our different organizations do in our community.
That's correct. And it's the same thing with us. We're down there at DCTV. We're at the Strady Center for the Arts. Even if we had, it's a lot of us older generation that are doing these things. And to get the young kids interested, to see the opportunity to even meet people like you, mm-hmm. and your wife. I mean, we're in contact with her all the time.
Yep.
She's a great person, always has the good vision of what's going to go on and what can make things happen. I just want to, if we can we get the old president in here?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the old president would love to come in and speak. Well, he's the current president.
Yeah, but he's going to be old.
But he will be out here in a month or two, so.
Hi.
And will you give everybody your name?
My name is Steve Furness.
See, now you're going to have all these people named Steve Furness. Oh, okay. No, share your name. I guess that's what I should have said.
Share my name. There
yeah.
You go.
So you've had a wonderful run. How long is a presidency?
So we go from June to June, typically is what our presidential year is. It's been kind of easy, quite frankly. Everything got canceled. We got to take on the virtual meetings this year, so we had a lot of old people conquer Zoom, which was entertaining to say the least. But no, it's presented its own challenges in this year because we have had to be conservative in the manner in which we typically disperse money to different organizations and events that we like to help support. So that's been a little challenging, but events like this are what keep us going, and the communities. Participation in those events is what really keeps us going, and so we're glad that we've had a significant turnout here today, and hopefully it'll restock our club fund, and we can contribute to different organizations and events throughout the community going forward.
And that's the other thing that it's about. I don't think people understand on the nonprofits what we do.
Absolutely.
Behind the scenes that you don't get a lot of press on, So, say I want to become a Lion.
Yes.
What would I do?
Well, you can go to the Lions International website. There is an application on there. You can fill out that application. And then if you want to go onto our Facebook page, it has some contact information on there for where you can send that application into. We meet every first and third Thursdays of the month. Our normal meeting spot is the First Presbyterian Church on Washington. Due to the last year and the restrictions that we've had, we've been meeting at Laddie's Grove or Veterans Memorial Park for the ability to be outside and social distance at that point. And we've also had a lot of Zoom meetings in the winter months when it hasn't been too nice to be out there. But I anticipate we will be able to be back at First Presbyterian for our noontime lunches. And again, they're every first and third Thursday from noon to one. So you'd start out by going to Lions Club International, filling out that application, and then we'll be in contact with you to invite you to one of those meetings. Also, if you know a Lions Club member, ask them about it, and we're always more than happy to bring guests to our lunches and meetings, and we can start the application process that way as well.
And I think the great thing is with the Facebook availability for
yes, absolutely.
The organizations,
absolutely.
To people to get to, because I'm not that smart to know that you guys started in 41. I just happened to look it up real quick, and I saw that, in 2016 you had 75 years, so I go, ooh, that's been 5 years.
Yeah.
I thank you.
Well, we thank you.
And I hope that everybody will come down here and enjoy.
We hope so, too, and we hope to make this an annual tradition, hopefully.
That'll be great. And yeah. You need volunteers, don't
you? We always need volunteers, so never never feel shy.
Do you have
shy
an 800 number I can call?
No 800 number, unfortunately, but again.
Just go on Facebook.
Just go on to Facebook. Our managers of that page are active in responding, so we'll get back to you as soon as we can.
Yeah, well, the trouble is you got Sean's picture on there with that interview. It kind of takes over the whole screen.
Yeah, that's true. But we'll have to get another picture out there, a more appeasing one, right?
There you go. Well, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you very much, and thank you guys for all that you do.
Yes,
great talking
sir.
To you.
Take care.
Have a good one.
Well, this is your man on the sidewalk. I'm out of here. Everybody else on the street, but.
Shaboom, shaboom. Ya la 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 la. Shaboom, shaboom. Every time I look at you, something is on my mind. If you do what I want you to, baby, we'd be so far. Life could be a dream.
Okay, here we are at Pete Lundberg, old friends, known him for a lot of years.
Yeah. 50 plus.
And we've done a few crazy things together.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, yeah.
And Peter, what I want to know is, the first thing is, how long have we done this raffle?
Rotary started it about 30 years ago in round figures. I might be a year or two off one way or the other, but Jerry Sarek came up with the idea back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
And it's been going strong ever since. And, you know, we raise about, $60,000 off the profits. And that all comes right back to all of the agencies and communities, the Boy Scout, the people who send in applications. They're the ones that benefit from it.
Yeah. And if the one thing I'd like to know, because I was just down talking to the Lions, too.
Uh-huh.
If I wanted to join a Rotary or know anything about them, do you have a Facebook I go to? Or?
Well, we have a Facebook page. We're still trying to find someone to manage that Facebook page, and it is way outdated at the moment. But almost ask anybody. You know, my number is published in the phone book, and, you know, give me a call, and I can hook you up.
You can hook
because I'll tell you, it's a service, a worldwide service organization, and we are about 8 million strong around the world.
Wow.
And so we do great things all over. Polio eradication is our big focus in the world.
Uh-huh.
And we're down to Nigeria is our last.
Wow.
India hasn't had any in, oh gosh, I want to say 6 months, 8 months. You have to go 2 years before you can be termed polio free.
Uh-huh.
But Nigeria keeps getting these little teeny one case, two case things. But it's a tribal situation there. Getting to the leaders to understand we're not poisoning them.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you, it's been good.
It's amazing because there's a lot. I was talking down before is, people don't understand what these organizations are.
That's it.
They just do not understand. And to get the younger people involved in this, I think we need to give more information to let them know this is more than just raffling off
a very nice car. It's a lot more than a car.
Did you get that out of Bill Dirk's garage?
Actually, we got it out of Estill's
garage.
Oh,
Estill, well, that's Bill.
Bob, we got out of his garage.
Bill keeps his out there, too. I just wanted you to know. But... So, you're down here today, tickets are?
$125. We're also selling a $5 chance, 25 of those tickets, you have a chance to win.
A ticket?
A ticket that'll be in the raffle.
Wow, and you only sell so many tickets?
1,000.
Yeah.
So the odds are a lot better.
Oh, yeah.
Than if you were just out there trying to
hit
win the
Powerball. Yeah.
Hit the Powerball.
Yeah.
You betcha.
I spent enough money, I could have bought two houses by now.
Well, and you know, you can take the car or you can take 40 plus thousand in your pocket.
Oh, is that right? You don't have to take the car?
You do not have to take the car.
Because I don't think I could get in and out of that car.
That's my problem.
You know, in my day, I would have. I'd have loved to have had it.
Mm-hmm.
But, Peter, I want to thank you.
You're most welcome.
And I hope everybody enjoys themselves down here. Great turnout. Beautiful day.
Isn't it, though?
I can't get over the day. You know.
Just, I mean, it always rains on this day.
Yeah.
And snowed definitely. A couple times.
That's, well, I told the Lions are all excited we're going to have a Halloween parade this year. And I said, yeah, I miss getting wet.
You know,
that's the whole thing there. But
yeah.
Once again, Pete, thank you.
Thank you.
And I hope you have best day.
You guys have a great day out here and keep up the good work.
Yeah. We will. We're the only two they could find, you know.
Well,
we get any older, they're going to have to wheel us around.
I noticed when you were getting off the back of the cart there,
a little slower.
It's a little slower than you were a couple years ago.
Yeah, I know. I can't jump off like I used to.
Oh, I tell you.
Oh, well.
We
thank
do have
you.
A good time. Thank you.
Okay. is this your first Lilac Fest?
Yes.
It is?
Yep.
And you both got wilted
organic fur.
They're all for her, huh?
Oh, yeah.
And you've been here more than once?
Yes, sir.
How many times have you been?
I moved back to Defiance 9 years ago, so this is my ninth year, with the exception of last year when we didn't have one.
Really?
Yes.
Well, that is cool. So you come every year. Do you get a bush every year?
Yes, I do, and they die every year.
I wonder why.
Yeah.
I'm not an expert on these things, but yeah. I'm telling you, this is very interesting. So, well, I'm glad, because that's what we want to know. So you heard about this from her.
Yeah.
When you moved back here.
Yes, sir.
Did you just find it from information?
Word of mouth. I work downtown on the corner, so word of mouth is how I heard about it.
Okay.
So.
You awesome. Work on the corner.
Oi.
Oi. Boy, did she put her foot in that. No. I understand. Well, thank you.
Thank
that's
you.
That's what we need to know, is that you're enjoying yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we are.
I can't get over the vendors.
It's awesome. It's great to see everybody outside again.
Wow. I think we deserve it.
Yes, we do.
We've had enough.
Oh, yeah.
We've had enough.
Okay. Well, thank you, and have
thank
a good
you.
Day.
You too.
Sure, sir.
All right. Put our channel 1021, and that's where we're at.
Oh,
but what
TV?
They ask us to do is to ask everybody, is this your first Lilac Festival?
It is not our first Lilac Festival.
No?
No.
How many have you been to?
I don't know.
We've been to one other one.
One yeah. other one?
Yes.
And what is your name?
Harper.
Harper.
Harper? No kidding. That's my name.
Oh.
I'll be dark.
Do you believe that?
We're twins. So this is your second one.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, are you from this area?
Yes, from Defiance. We go to Tenora. Say, go Rams.
Go Rams.
Go Rams.
Yeah, Mr. That's, Spiller.
Yeah. See?
Yep.
Mr. Spiller, he's my main cameraman.
That's, oh, I see.
Whenever I need somebody, he always goes, why me? So, well, it was nice meeting you.
It was nice to meet you, too.
I hope you have a wonderful day.
You, too. Thank you. All enjoy right. the sunshine.
Hey, ding dong, a lang a lang a lang. Boom, ba-do, 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 ba-do. Oh, life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Hello, hello again. Shaboom, and hope we'll meet again.
Oh, life could be a dream if only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Now every time I look at you, something is on my mind. If you do what I want you to,
baby, we'd be so far.
Oh, life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Shaboom, shaboom, ya-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, shaboom, shaboom, ya-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, shaboom, shaboom, ya-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, shaboom. Shaboom, shaboom, ya-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, shaboom, shaboom, ya-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, shaboom, shaboom, ya-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, shaboom. I look at you, something is on my mind. If you do what I want you to, baby, we'd be so fine. Life could be a dream.
I can't, right? I gotta go work.
You gotta go work, and you're from?
Wisconsin.
Why?
Because my in-laws, they have a restaurant at the Vagabond Village. I gotta work.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, I'm supposed to be working now, so don't tell them I'm not there.
I won't.
I'm like playing hooky.
I won't.
Okay.
I like Vagabond.
All right.
I used to be out there all the time when I was allowed out of the house. You know?
They let you out every once in a while.
Well, is this your first Lilac Festival?
This is my first Lilac Festival.
And what do you think so far?
I'm in love with it. I love the crafters. I didn't get a little lilac tree, though, but we're not blooming by us. You're blooming here.
Yeah.
We're a little behind.
Well,
you,
we're
Wisconsin.
Blooming idiots.
Yeah.
And,
we're
you know, there's.
Good call.
And I like the one standing off camera here.
I know. Look you at know, her. Look
she
at her.
She thinks she's not going to be on.
No. She thinks we're not moving around the picture.
Is there?
Yeah.
I don't know.
So you're enjoying yourself then?
Oh,
It's a good time. Yeah, great. A little vendor.
And how about you guys? This year?
Oh yeah. Oh no, I've been here before.
Have you?
Yeah.
Why?
Because
you like
she's
it.
She's a local.
Yeah.
I know.
We have to come.
You support local. That's what's important right now.
The whole thing is, I can't get over today. I think it's a great day today.
It's a beautiful day. Yeah. Could have been colder, could have been rainier, so you guys fared well.
Did you bring any cheese with you, by the way?
No, but I brought beer.
Did you?
Uh-huh.
Oh, God, not Milwaukee's best.
No, New Glarus.
Oh, uh-oh.
Uh-huh.
Uh-oh. Catch up, we're doing back later.
Oh, geez. Yeah. Well, I'm not in the Navy anymore, so I...
Oh, that's a good thing.
Well, hey, have a good day.
Thank you.
And thanks for stopping.
Absolutely.
All right, bye-bye. So, Stacy, it's been a while since I got to talk to you.
Yes.
I wanted to talk to you before the egg thing went on, and instead I call for Stephanie. I don't know why it stuck in my head rather than Stacy. And, of course, Kate says, I think you got the wrong person. But I never went beyond that. And what I want to know is, since you're not the president anymore, who is?
Scott Baker is now the president.
Scott is?
Yes, and Mary Baker is our treasurer.
Oh, well, cool.
So,
now this is the, I want people to know this is the Defiant Society of Artists.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
And we've got a wonderful display down here at the Lilac Fest. I don't want Eric to pan Rosie's stuff, but did you? So, see, he's not listening to me. It's because she paid him off. So any, what's the plans for the future, do you know?
Well, now that the world is opening back up after the COVID crisis, the Art Society is trying to have a few of our members come once or twice a week in the evening to paint together. We're still holding our monthly meetings. And a lot of us have still been working on our art at home in the last 18 months and ready to get back out to shows
and
festivals.
And you really had a lot of time to practice now, haven't you?
We have. I've been working on my own business, Libra Palette. I do watercolors and acrylics, and I'm set up down there. Ann Panning is one of our members. She's brought her painted slates today. She does oil and acrylic, I believe. We have Kate Smolik, obviously, with pet portraits, and does beautiful work on animals and acrylic. So we each offer something a little different, and we're just excited to get back into the flow.
Now, you said you have your own?
I started my own small business from home 3 years ago when I retired. Started to paint. I'd never really spent a lot of time at it before. And lo and behold, people asked if they could buy it, so I decided I'd turn it into a small business. So it's been fun retirement hobby.
Something you can do in the home. When you get to the home, they give you a brush and off you go, right?
Yes, that's true.
Now, let me ask you this. What if I wanted to join the Art Society? What would it take?
Well, our Art Society dues are $35 a year, and for that you get your own like 4-foot card table space. You bring your own supplies. You'll have a key to the Art Society studio, so you can come and go as you please to paint.
Okay.
Several of our artists don't have room at home, so they depend on having a space at the Art Society, and that their dues gets them that, and then it also gets them out here to the Lilac Festival to paint with us and sell their work if they want. And 15% commission of everything sold today goes to the Art Society to help maintain our organization.
Now, do you have non-painting members?
We do have non-painting members. Some of those members make the scrubbies that we sell for kitchen scrubbing. Mary Baker is one of our great scrubby makers. And Becky Lawson is learning to make scrubbies. They also man our bake sales, and they'll do baked goods so that we have additional income for the Art Society that way. And we have members who just pay their dues, and they say, well, we'll come and help at an event, but we don't have time to paint, or we don't know if we want to paint. And that's fine, too. We need a little help from everybody, and that's keeping us in the community.
So do you look for volunteers, too, to help
always.
You, like, with setup and...
Well, we could always use that. A lot of us are used to trucking our own stuff and taking ibuprofen later. So we could always use volunteers, but we really don't have a lot of the, you know, younger, stronger members. So we're We'd love that.
Now, if I wanted to volunteer, do you have a website I could go to?
We have a Facebook page. Defiant Society of Artists is on Facebook, and you can message us through that. I have some business cards for the Art Society with me today, and we're located at 522 Pearl Street on the corner of Pearl and Greer by the college.
And you've been there since 1948?
1947, I believe.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
See, I always thought it was 48 because that was the year I was born.
You're always making it about you.
Yeah,
Al.
See, it's about me.
You're always making it about you.
They built the building because of me.
Yeah. We're still working on that brass plate. For the corner.
The one that's at the bottom of the auger.
Yeah, there's probably something in a time capsule buried from 1948.
One of my diapers is in there. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And
for
I hope you have a wonderful
us.
Day.
Thank you. I will.
And I hope the sales go through the roof.
Well,
we have a beautiful day. It's beautiful group of people. I think we all deserve this.
Yes, we do.
We have been good.
People are excited to be out. You can just feel it in the air.
Yes. Matter of fact, I've had not only just two COVID shots, I have aliases I give them, and I'm up to 17 shots now. And I feel great.
Yeah. I had my one dose J&J, and I'm doing just fine.
And you look just fine.
Thank you.
And I hope the rest of your day is fine. So, once again, this is the man on the sidewalk saying adios.